colonial state-funded enterprise of the United States. This war would not continue for one day without the billions and billions, somewhere in the excess of $8 billion that they have supplied to the apartheid state in the last 12 months. The bombs that we see falling on the children of Palestine and the children of Lebanon.
For nearly 12 months, we've witnessed unspeakable horrors. Israel slaughtering women and children, silencing the media that is reporting on their crimes, killing UN workers who are only trying to help the people of Gaza, even killing aid workers, one of whom was an Australian citizen. That is why I stand here before you tonight, not because of my heritage, but because of my humanity.
And as an American war, we also demand that our government ends the political support for the apartheid state. Words like deeply concerned or urging restraint do not cut it when in 30 minutes, the apartheid state murdered 500 people in Lebanon.
We've been told by the Israeli government that all of this started in October, that they're merely defending themselves from their so-called evil neighbours.
It is a great shame and a disappointment that none of our political leaders are capable of the fundamental humanity to be able to make simple statements to condemn that sort of violence.
Who has killed 40,000 people in Gaza, mostly women and children? Who has bombed hospitals where the sick and the wounded lie helpless? Who has blown up schools, turning places of learning into rubble? The answer is simple. It's Israel, no one else.
And let's talk about the pager attack. What sort of world are we bequeathing when the terrorist state, the terrorist apartheid state of Israel can weaponize personal devices and blow up thousands and thousands of people in Lebanon in the last week? And do we hear condemnation from our political leaders or our media? To them it's audacious, to them it's targeted. It's targeted to blow the eyes out of doctors and nurses. It's targeted to blow the hands off civil servants who work for the Lebanese government. This is naked terrorism, and yet the double standard of our leaders is witnessed by all of us in the last week.
Israel is not this innocent little nation that it wants the world to believe it is. For decades, it has stolen land, displaced families, and taken innocent lives. Did you know that Israel has invaded Lebanon not once, not twice, but in 1978, 1982, and again in 2006?
And as we move past the International Day of Peace as declared by the United Nations, we live in a world where the fundamental principles of international humanitarian law and human rights is dissolving before our eyes. Because if they can blow up children in Lebanon with these devices, if they can blow the eyes out of people, if they can blow their hands off and their hips apart, we can rest assured that is coming to all of us. So we stand here as humanity to say that we do not accept a world where this is acceptable. We do not accept a world where the indiscriminate bombing of people is acceptable. We are united in our quest for justice, freedom, and equality.